is another important video, and the topic is related to all the important case law series of 2024. So this is another important video, and the question is, just imagine ki if you have a contract with the government and the government has promised with you to provide you some services or benefits, but the later stage is the government refused to provide you the same thing which is promised, what kind of remedy is available to you? The answer is, of course, the remedy is available, and the remedy is available under Article 226 of the Constitution of India, which gives you the remedy to claim mandamus. You can request the court to issue directions to the particular authority, which is the government authority, to apply these promises, to fulfill those promises which you already promised to the claimant. So suppose when you have been appointed in a particular university and it has been promised to you that they will provide you some kind of benefits as per their services norms, but at the later stage the university is refusing you to provide this remedy, question comes whether the High Court is given the power to provide you remedy under this term. The answer is yes, but the point is, if the government authority is there and it has promised to you any services, then you can claim the remedy of mandamus. Just imagine if the person, the authority which is promising you that particular services or commitment is taken out from the private authority. Will you get any remedy? Will you go for legitimate expectation, which is a very basic doctrine under the constitution law? So today I'm going to discuss with this new case law, that is Army Welfare Education Society, New Delhi versus Sunil Kumar Sharma and others. In this judgment, the question was that the claimant said that, can I not be provided the remedy as I was asking about the legitimate expectation? And this legitimate expectation was against the particular authority, which was not a government authority. So the question was, will that person will get the remedy or not? So in the judgment, Supreme Court issued some guidelines. So you can look at the screen, you will find the following guidelines issued by the Supreme Court of India, wherein Supreme Court clearly mentioned that you can claim mandamus remedy, but the mandamus remedy is provided to you in terms when the government authority is promised to you. यहाँ पर द पॉइंट वॉज सुप्रीम कोर्ट क्लियरली सेड दैट इफ लेजिटिमेट एक्सपेक्टेशन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लेजिटिमेट एक्सपेक्टेशन लेजिटिमेट एक्सपेक्टेशन मीन्स द एक्सपेक्टेशन विच यू हैव एंड इट वॉज क्रिएटेड बिकॉज द पर्टिकुलर अथॉरिटी हैज प्रॉमिस्ड टू यू समथिंग सो वंस द गवर्नमेंट अथॉरिटी हैज प्रॉमिस्ड टू यू दैट दे विल प्रोवाइड यू समथिंग एट द लेटर स्टेज And if the commitment is a legal commitment, and in term of this commitment you have done something in the furtherance of that promise, that is called legitimate expectation. Question is, how can we enforce the legitimate expectation against the person who is a private authority? The first guideline which was issued was that a legitimate expectation must be based on a right as opposed to a mere hope, wish or anticipation. So suppose I am hoping that some beneficial interest will be conferred on me, it cannot be covered into the legitimate expectation. The legitimate expectation arises only those promises which are well settled under the contract. This is the first rule. Second point is that legitimate expectation must arise either from a express promise or an implied promise or a consistent past practices which are regularly done and the custom followed by that authority. So if generally it is a custom provided by the customary authority, by the particular authority, that they usually provide to all its employees the accommodation services. So when it is a common customary practice that they provide to all the employees the accommodation services, and now they are refusing you to provide these accommodation services, then you can say yes, it is a legitimate expectation. So only you believe that this is kind of things to be done to me, this is not a valid expectation. Third point, which is important, that expectation that is based on a sporadic or casual or random acts, or which is unreasonable, illogical or invalid, cannot be treated as a legitimate expectation. If something is promised to you by any government authority which is simply illogical, which is simply inconsistent, which is simply unlawful, so how can you claim that remedy? That is another expectation that the Supreme Court has held. Other important point, that legitimate expectation operates in relation to the both, either it is a substantive or it is a procedural matter. So not just in the substantive matter, substantive benefits you are going to claim, but also if some legitimate expectation in terms of procedure you are expecting and it is a valid procedure, it is a valid expectation, then you can claim that legitimate expectation. Another point the Supreme Court further elaborated that legitimate expectation operates in the realm of public law, that is a plea of legitimate action can be taken only against the public authority. So that was the crux, that was the main important point in this case law, where Supreme Court clearly mentioned that you can expect the legitimate expectation against the government authority, not against the private person. So that was very important point that Supreme Court held. Another important point, which was the last point as a guideline issued by the Supreme Court, that legitimate expectation based on past practices can only be taken by someone who has dealing or negotiations with a public authority. It cannot be invoked by a total stranger to the authority merely on the ground that the authority has a duty to perform that. So these were the already six parameters which were issued by the Supreme Court, that if you want to claim remedy from any Supreme Court, the High Court, claiming that that was my legitimate expectation and the authority has refused to promise that condition, or the authority has committed a breach on the promise, you can claim the remedy only when you are expecting that kind which is a legitimate expectation. So how can we say the condition is a legitimate expectation? That was clearly elaborated in this case. So this was all. Thanks for watching this video.